Hey mamas, thank you so much for joining me for another episode of Hustle Like a Mom, where we hope that you will laugh with us, learn from us, and also learn to live your happy formula life. And I have somebody here today who's going to help you do just that. I'm joined by Jessica Luengo, who is the founder of these beautiful as well as healthy Naturally Clean Eats bars. So I can talk about you and what you do for days, but I want you to tell all these mamas what Clean Eats is all about.
Well, thank you so much for having me, first of all. I'm a big fan of you, and I love that you support moms that work, and I just think that we should all support each other, and I'm a big fan of that. So anyways, I was a Pilates instructor for 10 years. I just trained clients that I kind of grew up with. It was my job right after, a little bit after I graduated college, and I just kept doing it and had my own private studio in Beverly Hills. And I had the same clients for a long time. Like, we kind of went through marriage and kids and all those like big lifetime things. Yeah, so I was training them for their weddings and then after they would have the baby and all through their pregnancy. So when I got pregnant, I was always eating some kind of bar, and I would make a version of these at my house. They weren't exactly these, because when I did decide to make this a business, I decided to find a co-packer that could basically do all the FDA regulations and make sure all that stuff kind of scares me, so I want to make sure that it's all legal.
I was going to say, you know, just hearing those three little words, like FDA and then followed by regulations, probably scares a lot of people.
Yeah.
But you just said something that I also recently learned was, so let's just get this. Let us get out there. You started this in 2017. We are just midway through 2018, and I feel like I'm already seeing these bars everywhere, and not just in my house.
Thank you.
So before we get into the hows, let's get into the, oh my gosh, like literally, what gave you the courage to decide, you know what, there's nothing on the market the way I feel that, you know, it should
right.
be, and I'm just gonna go into the health bar industry, which is packed right now.
It is. It's really oversaturated, but I think that's a big reason why I wanted to come out with these bars, because there is just such a huge demand for healthy convenience on the go, and more people are looking for more calorie-controlled options, or they want to kind of watch their macros, or they just really want like a healthy meal or snack that they can trust, and grabbing something sometimes from the packaged food aisle always feels like you're compromising.
I know. It's either, right, it's either it doesn't taste good, but it's good for you, or
right.
the other way around.
Right.
And I love what you said. You say, if you can't pronounce the ingredients, they shouldn't be inside. So
yeah.
I love that challenge.
Yeah, like you shouldn't be eating them. So, you know, I think that when I was, I tried to keep the recipe as closest to what I always found in my kitchen. The biggest thing that I get from people is like, this is the bar that I want to make at home, like off of Pinterest or Instagram.
Right.
I mean, now it's Instagram, but when I started, it was Pinterest. And, you know, but people just didn't have the time to go out and buy the ingredients and blend everything together and press it and freeze it, whatever it was, you know?
I think we're all about making mom's life a little bit easier, and I can tell you that, at least in my home, this makes my life easier. Do you get a lot of moms that say, I give this to my kids too? Do you talk about that as far as like with your brand? Is this something that we can give to our kids?
Yes, this is very safe to give to children. There's nothing in there that is not natural. So even there's no flavors added to these. A lot of the most popular protein bars have a flavor to them. I know you think it says like three or four things on the front, but if you turn it over and read the ingredient list, it's full disclosure on the back. So always be a label reader, and definitely, you know, see what you're feeding yourself and your kids and your family. I tested them on my husband, who's a big protein guy. I mean, these are not totally protein packed. They're very balanced. So they have an equal amount of healthy fats,
fiber,
very high fiber, and very low sugar, only 7 grams from dates. So, you know, a lot of the bars that you think are really high in protein, also look at those sugars, because most of the time they're 13 grams or more. These are at a low 7 grams. So, you know, also look at sugar alcohol that is not digested properly in the system. It's really bad for health gut.
Mama knows her stuff. Mama knows her stuff, which is probably why we've been crushing it. It's really only been a year. How have you used social medias? Because I know a lot of moms out there, they, you know, they want to start a business. They have an idea in their head. How have you used social media to boost your business? Because you've really done a great job. I follow you. I follow your kids' life, your mom life, your entrepreneur life.
Thank you. I am really, I am not a social media expert. I have learned from some of the best. You know, I have amazing bloggers and influencers who follow me and who I've become friends with now, who have just supported the Baris like so genuinely. And, you know, I can't afford to pay people to talk about these bars. It's just not in my budget. This is a total startup. So the people who do talk about them or post about them, that is a real genuine thing. I just want everybody to know that. You know, a lot of people are paid by these big companies, and that's nothing against the bloggers or the influencers, like more power to you, but it's just not, that's not what this company is about.
She's stream budget.
Yeah, this is stream budget. Everything is going towards like these bars. I'm flying like, out here to do interviews with you.
Like, what can you do? It's like, what can you do for $5? Like, okay, let me see.
Definitely. And you know, and these are real ingredients. So, you know, we're never gonna be the cheapest bar on the market. We're not gonna be 99 cents.
Yeah, so tell everybody.
So these retail for $3.99.
Okay.
And they're mostly all organic ingredients. And we really pick the highest ingredients to work with. You know, that's the thing. So we really get highly sourced ingredients. Everything is vegan, gluten-free, non-GMO. Again, nothing processed or artificial. And just things that you want to give your family and your kids, you know? And we have some big retailers coming up, so
yay.
I'm hoping to make more headway on the East Coast. We're getting out there on the West Coast, but we're trying to
expand. She's a West Coast girl. She's literally here for 2 days, so I'm so excited that you're here. And the first thing I asked you was because I thought for some reason you brought one of the babies, but you're like, I did not.
No, the kids are 2 and 5, so I give it up for the mamas in New York City because just the transportation gives me heart palpitations. I don't know. It's
hard on both coasts and down
crazy.
The center.
Yeah.
We all hustle like a mom. So speaking of hustle like a mom, what are some tools that help you, you know, build your business but also be the mom that you want to be? And I know you're pretty active. You're there. I see the kids with you on some of the trips when she's dropping off packages on Instagram. Who helps you? Your sort of squad or your tools or your people?
You know, I have a lot of close family friends, and you know, anyone from like my cousin who, you know, is an event planner, but I pull her in for a lot of the conferences, you know, food conferences, to you know, my husband is my number one fan. He always supports me, and he helps me think about things in a different way. And also gives a fresher, he's very finance and very like to the point, very entrepreneur in the fact of like, this should be making money and what are our numbers and this, where I'm very creative. And I'm like, oh, I want to do this flavor with this. And he's like okay, so anyways, yeah, what are we going to do that makes money? You know, so he's very much, it's a good balance, you know?
And I think that's what I actually have that in my home too.
Do you?
It's really important to be able to have somebody, whether it's your husband or your any business partner, acquaintance, that to be able to say, you know, that's a great idea. I always say, let's park it. We're gonna park this car for a minute.
I'm gonna use that.
And then we're gonna maybe take it out of the garage at some point, but that's sort of what my husband does for me too.
Right.
So aside from obviously your husband and help from family, what helps you stay organized so that you can be the mompreneur that you are and continue to flourish?
You know, I think balance in the home is really good. We have a lot of help just from family and from each other, you know. Like I said, like my husband and I, we both work full-time jobs, we both work our butt off, but we're really there for each other. And the fact of like, when I had to go to New York, you know, I'm here and he's home with the kids, like, you know, and vice versa, he was here a few weeks ago. So it was just, you know, we really balance each other's schedule out. And, you know, the kids, I have to say, kids really keep it light. You know, even when you're having a stressful day, it really helps you balance in the fact of, you know, we don't have any phones at dinner. We really try.
Yes.
Sometimes.
It's the ideal that doesn't always happen.
Yeah.
Try. Good.
Sometimes we're waiting for a call and, you know,
it's
we
like,
need the phone.
It's just right here.
Yeah, just like right here. And if it vibrates, we pick it up. But, you know, we really try to show our kids like a lot of love and attention. And, you know, we take them to school and pick them up. And, you know, even if we have to work, they're 2 and 5. So my 2-year-old needs a little bit more attention than my 5-year-old. She's much more independent. But it's good. That's how we kind of balance it, in the fact of I try to do my business as much as I can from the hours of 9 to 3 when they're in preschool. And then when I pick them up, it's kind of like a switch off, where like I still have these emails to do, so he'll watch the kids, or if he has stuff to do, then I'll watch the kids and I'll do stuff later.
And then do you flip back after they go to bed sometimes?
Sometimes, yeah. Sometimes, like, you know, we'll put the kids to bed and then we'll both be on our computers finishing up work or something, or, you know, I'm not afraid to work on the weekends. You know, it's not the best thing, because you really want those weekends to be with your kids and family. So we really, especially Sundays, we really try to dedicate Sunday to family day, family time.
So that's kind of like your mom non-negotiable.
Yeah. Although I flew out here on Sunday, so yeah, but I broke that. But you know, I always say,
because I think we, you know, I do a lot of these interviews, and everybody always has their like non-negotiables, but there's always a wiggle room. It just, if you set them, then they're like, there's always the exception, but that's like, okay, that's my Sunday. And if one time I have to fly out, yeah, you sort of balance it out. So before we wrap it up, any tips you have for entrepreneurs out there, mompreneur who wants to specifically actually maybe even go into the, you know, the food space, because I feel like that's such a hard industry to go
to
break
into. I
have to
say, I never realized how big the food space was until I got into it, and it's just this whole world. I mean, when I was a teenager, I used to waitress. I waitress all through college, and I was like, I know restaurants, I know food, I like food.
I'm in.
I can do this.
That's a good resume.
And then you start going to these conferences, and it's just, there's so many things. I mean, we launched the bars, and a very good, an old client of mine, I went to an event, and her brother-in-law was there, who happened to be a connection to a big grocery store in LA called Air One, which is like a big natural foods store. And he literally, I had these two flavors at the time, and he literally ripped one open, took a bite, and said, these are effing amazing, they need to launch in Air One.
Nice.
And it was just so cool. It was the day before we officially launched the website, and I had a meeting with Air One, and we got in that day. And it was a whirlwind from there. So I think my plan was always to keep Pilates and do this business. And I think after a couple months, I realized that that was not a possibility unless I wanted to hire someone to take this
on. So would you say your tip is just go all in? If you can, do you see the opportunity?
I think
just go
so.
All in.
You know, I think when it became reality that I had to choose between Pilates and this, you know, my husband said to me, well, do you want this as a hobby, or do you want this as a business? Like, do you want to take this to the next level, or are you okay just doing like, I can just sell to a couple stores, and you know, it's just it. And I really wanted to bring it to the next level. I wanted to grow it and see what it can do. And you know, I definitely believe in the product. You know, there's exciting things to come, and we're always formulating, like, maybe we'll add this or take this away or something fun. So, you know, it's exciting to see what it could bring, and that's where my creative juices go. And to be honest, I had spent so many years training people to be their best, healthiest, fit self, and I felt like there was a real lack of healthy options for convenience foods for them, and that was really deterring them from getting to their goals. And so this is just another way to help people just on a bigger scale.
I love it. So we're going to learn to go beyond the hobby if you want to.
If you want to. You don't have to.
You don't have to. So if you want to go beyond the hobby or continue in the hustle that you are doing right now, go for it, but just live your happy formula life, mama. Thank you so much for tuning into this great interview. Thank you, Jessica, for flying out just for me, just for you guys. Thank you, guys,
and
enjoy the next episode. Bye.
Bye.